Hey, good afternoon, you guys. This is Boris Portnoy, Bergen County Realtor. I'm hanging out here with Max, my main man, Max. And it's a Sunday afternoon, and it's kind of a lazy Sunday. It's pouring rain outside, so I decided to just take this moment and upload a video about dual tracking, foreclosure dual tracking. So what dual tracking means is when the banks are simultaneously negotiating a loan modification with you and also pushing forward towards a foreclosure auction date. They may have already initiated a foreclosure, but if there's a loan modification in the works, the banks are now obligated by federal law under RESPA, the Real Estate Settlement and Procedures Act. They're obligated to give you the opportunity, which is the RESPA laws were revamped, part of the Dodd-Frank laws following the 08 recession, the subprime mortgage scandals. So part of these new Dodd-Frank revamped laws was they've outlawed dual tracking. So what dual tracking is when you'll have simultaneously a loan modification and a foreclosure action in the works. If you have an open foreclosure in the court dockets, the banks are now obligated to work out your loan modification prior to scheduling pushing forward with the foreclosure. So if you already have a foreclosure and you've applied for a loan modification, the foreclosure must be legally halted. You can't push forward with any filing for motions for default or filing for motions of possession. You can't do these things. You have to now wait until the loan modification is worked out, either approved or denied, but nevertheless there has to be a resolution to your loan modification application before the lenders can push forward with their foreclosures. So that's what dual tracking is. I just wanted to quickly upload this video and educate people. Also, what I'll mention about loan modification is often lenders will deny these loan modifications because the paperwork is incomplete, not because you aren't eligible for it, but because the paperwork is incomplete, they've lost paperwork, they didn't calculate your income properly, you didn't document either various sources of income, or they didn't give you credit for various sources of income, which made the payment unaffordable. So it's important that you work with an expert who knows the loan modification process in order to increase the likelihood of getting your loan modification approved. And why are lenders, servicers, the services handle the customer aspect, the customer service aspect on behalf of the mortgage holder. Why are servicers interested in denying your loan modification? The reason being is because servicers make a lot more money when your home goes into foreclosure as opposed to simply servicing your loan. When they simply service your loan, they collect a fee every month for collecting the payment and handling the customer service aspect. But when the home goes into foreclosure and they gain possession of the home, now they're handling other aspects of they're handling property management, they're handling legal services, and they're entitled to more fees. It's much more profitable for them to push a home into foreclosure as opposed to approve a loan modification. That's why it's imperative you work with somebody who's versed, expert with loan modifications to improve your likelihood of getting your loan modification approved, because in all honesty, the servicers are in their best interest to deny your loan modification. I hope I explained loan modifications and what dual tracking is. Thanks very much for listening, you guys.